Hi. As a cat owner, I often take time to admire the cutest little things on my small cats, but I don't often think about the beauty of big cats. This video is for the Animal Artists Collective, a group that creates artwork every other month to promote positive messages for animal welfare and conservation efforts. Each round, you can participate in a poll on Facebook where anyone can vote on which type of animal is chosen next. This time, the vote ended with an even tie between ungulates and carnivores, so you may notice the official group went with a different theme, while unofficial participants, like myself, were free to choose from either category. This happened to coincide with an important local issue regarding land management for the Florida Panther. Considering my love for felines, my choice was clear. As far as big cats are concerned, there's been a lot of focus in recent years on preserving the several thousand tigers left in the wild. Big organizations like National Geographic and other wildlife charities often use the tiger as an example of a majestic animal that needs our help. What I've noticed generally lacks media attention are the American wildcats, such as bobcats, lynx, ocelots, and puma, which brings me back to the Florida Panther. It's a subspecies of puma, which goes by many names, such as mountain lion, cougar, or panther. There are less than 200 of them still in the wild. There's a small area in southwest Florida that they call home, though in the past their range used to cover the whole southeastern United States. In recent years, they have not been using the Everglades habitat to much extent, and are centered in Big Cypress National Preserve, which borders a small area designated as the Florida Panther National Wildlife Refuge. Unfortunately, this area has several roads running through it, and each year about a dozen panthers die in vehicle accidents. The surrounding lands are both public and private lands, much of which is being considered for real estate development. If the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service approves the proposal, it will not only destroy over 20,000 acres of the panther's primary habitat, but create further issues with human interaction. New roads and cities are planned to house hundreds of thousands of people, which will surely hurt the panther's already struggling population numbers. With local farmers already wanting the panthers gone due to occasional livestock deaths, the government considers public tolerance of an animal when deciding which ones to protect. This is a complex problem, one the whole world shares. How can we preserve beautiful animals from going extinct while managing a peaceful coexistence? One of the ways they try to address concerns from farmers is a fund to cover compensation for livestock losses due to federal protected animals. It seems like the best way to protect these animals is to designate large pieces of land protected from land development, especially the creation of new roads, which are increasingly fragmenting Florida's landscape. But how do we protect land that people want to build on? The environmental organization called the Sierra Club pays attention to land proposals and alerts citizens when they can take action. They collect protest signatures and submit letters of objections to proposals that would hurt animals or the environment. I'll put more info about that in the description, and I would love to hear your ideas on how to best help and preserve wilderness areas. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you.
Ooh.